So if you want to learn how to create an amazing masking transition in Lumafusion, stay tuned. Hey there, welcome to the video. I'm Mark Brown from Editor's Keys. Now, if you're into video editing or Lumafusion, consider subscribing to the channel because that's what we're all about. And we're gonna have a ton more videos about Lumafusion. Now, in this video, we're gonna teach you how to do a real cool masking transition. And this has been one of the most popular videos we did for Premiere and Final Cut. So now as we're using Lumafusion a lot for our mobile editing workstation, I thought it would be a great time to bring this transition over to Lumafusion. Now, the way you do it inside Lumafusion is actually a little bit different compared to other video editing programs. So I thought we'd show you how we can do it the right way. Oh, and before we start the tutorial, a lot of people have been asking about this. This is the new Editor's Keys Lumafusion keyboard cover that we made with Lumafusion. So if you want to check one of these out for your smart keyboard and the magic keyboard coming soon, I'll put a link in the description below. But let's get into the tutorial. So here we are in Lumafusion. Now I've chosen two clips, and as we've talked about before, make sure you choose a clip that has an object or person covering the top to bottom of the frame, all the way through the shot, like this pillar for example. You can see it covers the whole frame so you can mask into the next clip. So find a good start and end point. The shortcut to cut is Command B if you have a keyboard for your iPad, and if not, it's the scissor icon here. So I'll start it here and finish it just after the pillar exits the frame. Step two is to now add an overlay title. You want to stretch this to fit the full length of the clip below. Now go into edit mode on this title by double tapping the clip. Find the point where you want the masking to start. So just as you see the line coming in. Now go back to your timeline again by clicking this arrow at the top left corner and make a cut with Command B and delete the first part. Now go back to edit mode on your text layer. Delete your text by clicking this icon. And now go over to this icon and add shape. And make sure you change this color to green. Now, drag this shape around to the middle part of your clip area around here and resize it so it fits the full frame. If you need to, duplicate the shape by clicking this icon right here. So now we have our first one done. Scroll through your timeline to check if it fits nicely. Now go to the start point and go about here and add a keyframe by clicking here. Now move a few frames further and do the same thing, making sure the shape fits the line of the wall or the object you're using. Now what you want to do is keep adding keyframes until you fill the whole frame with the green shape. It might take a little bit of time to get it all perfect, so don't worry if you make a few mistakes. What I'll do is I'll speed this part up now. Okay, so go to the start and clean this part up to match it. And now it should look like this, where the green shape comes in and then fills the whole frame. Right now, go to your timeline by clicking this arrow above, have a look at it and see how it is. I can see here that this bit needs editing, so if that's the case, just go back and fix it. And there you go, it looks a lot better. So once you've refined and made it look the best you can, go down to this icon here and click Export the project. Make sure it's in the correct settings for your project. Ours is 4K and 100 megabytes per second. Now, you'll see it appear here. So select this and delete what you've just done so it's just the exported file in here. Now, insert the clip you want to transition to and place it below the clip. Remember, if you make any mistakes, use the shortcut Command Z to undo or this little arrow here. Now, double tap your top layer and select this icon here at the bottom. Click on the key icon and select green screen key. So at first, it will look quite bad. So what you have to do is play around with the settings here. And what I found for our clips is the best settings are hue range around 40, saturation and brightness to about 70. And then when you scroll through, it looks so much better. But there's still a very harsh line here that looks really bad. So the way to fix this is to go over to the tool that looks like the water droplet here and add Gaussian 5. Instantly, you can see it looks a lot better, but now the whole clip is blurred. To fix this, go to Edit again and go to your keyframes. Now, find the spot where it just starts, add a keyframe and apply no blur. Then go one more frame across to where it begins, add another keyframe and increase the radius blur. So there you go, have a look and see if it needs refining. A good tip I always say is if you have both clips moving in the same direction, it makes the transition a lot smoother and seamless. Now, another tip to get this looking even better is to use speed ramping. Now, Lumafusion doesn't support speed ramping yet, so I'll show you another way to still achieve the same look. So just find the spot where you want it to speed up, cut the clip, then do the same where you want it to end. Make sure you do this on both clips. Then go into Edit by double tapping, click this icon here, which says speed and reverse, and increase the speed to about 3 times. And then make sure you do this to both clips. Now, I think that looks pretty great. Of course, you can adjust the speed to your liking too, but I think this works perfectly for our clips. Now, if you want to make it even more seamless, definitely add some sound effects and some music. So let's take a look at the final outcome. So there we go. I hope that has really helped you. Now, if you've got any questions about that, or if you just want to leave us a comment, make sure you do that below, because I promise we do actually get back to every single question asked. Now, remember, we are going to be doing a ton of videos all about Lumafusion. So if you want to see those, make sure you subscribe to the channel and then hit that little notification bell, and then you'll be notified every time one of these tutorials for Lumafusion goes live. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.